Guys, I'm going to talk to you about leveled questions today in case you missed the critical teach. So leveled questions is a simple idea to engage with a text. So level one questions are answered by the text. So I have Romeo and Juliet examples up here. They are factual based. There's a right and wrong answer. There's usually one right answer, but it is answered in the text. So there's level one questions. So from Romeo and Juliet, level one questions would be, who gave Juliet the magic sleeping potion? The answer is Friar Lawrence. That's answered for you in the text. Where was Juliet when Romeo was declaring his love for her? She was on the balcony. That's why it's called the balcony scene. So they're answered in the text. They're fact-based. Did you read? Did you understand, comprehend the basic meaning? A level two question is an open-ended question, meaning you have to have read the text in order to answer the question, but you are inferring an answer. There might be more than one right answer. So if I ask you for Romeo and Juliet, who is most responsible for Romeo and Juliet's death? I might say Friar Lawrence. You might say the parents. You might say Romeo and Juliet themselves. So we can have a discussion based on the character's actions. You have to have read the text, but there's not a one right or wrong answers. There's multiple answers that can be defended by the text. A level three question is a thematic question. You don't have to have actually read the text to answer the question. So usually I like to start with an idea. So in Romeo and Juliet, they have topics about love, family, immaturity, maturity. So then I ask myself, what is this text asking me about love? What is this text asking me about marriage? And then I formulate a question about what I think that text is asking me to think about in terms of that idea. So I chose love for my example, and I said, is love destructive when the participants are too young? I can use Romeo and Juliet to answer the question, and I definitely use Romeo and Juliet to pose the question because that's what the text was asking. However, I could have a discussion with an entire table of people who haven't read Romeo and Juliet, and they could use other examples, their own opinions, and that is really a level three question. I hope that's helpful. So when you're reading War of the Clowns, I want you to be thinking in terms of level questions. Have a great day. Happy reading.